night before Christmas, you live all alone in a one-bedroom house with a plastered ceiling. I had come down the chimney with presents together, and just to see who was home to live. I looked all around, a strange sight I didn't see. No utensils, no presents, not even a tree. I was talking by the fire, his boots filled with sand. On the wall hung pictures of far distant lands. With medals and badges of boards of all kinds, silver thought came to my mind. But this house was different, so dark and dirty. I knew I had found the home of a soldier once I could see clearly. I heard stories about him, I had to see more. So I walked down the hall, which opened the door. There he lies, silent and alone, curled on the floor, one bedroom home. His face still gentle, his room concessions. Not how I pictured the United States soldier. Was this the hero of whom I had just read? Curled up on his poncho, the floor over his head. His head was clean shaven, his weathered face in the air. I soon understood. This was more than a man. For I realized the family that I saw that night, older life these men who were willing to fight. Sooner or later, all children would play. Our grown-ups would celebrate my bright Christmas day. They all enjoyed the freedoms and sprung up in here. Because a soldier like this one lied on here. I couldn't help wonder how many lied alone on a cold Christmas Eve in a land far. Just the very thought brought a tear to my eye. I dropped to my knees and started to cry. The soldier awakened, I heard a rough voice. Santa, don't cry, this life is my choice. I fight for freedom, I don't ask for more. My life is my God, my country, my home. With that he rolled over and gripped them all to sleep. I couldn't control it, I continued to weep. I didn't want to leave him. Guardians of honor were willing to fight. Then the soldier rolled over and whispered with a voice so clean and pure. Curious, it's Christmas Day, all is secure. I looked at my watch,